Hello, 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 it's Dolly. Welcome to my channel, Scrapping on the Go. This process video is for everyday inspiration with Christy, Crystal, Daisy, Lisa, Jennifer, and myself. The inspiration piece is brought to you by myself. I snapped this photograph last year of Raspberry Swirl chocolate chip ice cream from BasketRobin. I cannot wait until I get another one of those this summer. So we like to go there about twice a year during the summertime because, as you all know, you can buy ice cream a lot cheaper at the stores. But it's fun to get those unique flavors or those ones that just come out certain times of the year. All right, so back to my layout. So this pattern paper of blue and yellow hearts and aqua is from Amy Tan. I'm backing my photograph against this older 8x8 paper from Pretty Little Studios. I think it's from 2017. I don't know the name of the collection. I'm sure it's not available. You know what? I haven't shopped on their site for a while. I think I need to throw them some business, even though I already did my annual purchase in the month of March. Oh well. All right, so this layout went a total different direction. I decided to use a lot of different bits and pieces and different types of elements. I use flat stickers, I use chipboard stickers, I used enamel dots, I use puffy stickers, I use clear stickers. I use that large pocket page there, and then just a few scraps. So this is one of those layouts that I call like Heinz 57. I just went to town. I didn't overthink it. I just kind of looked at the colors and just said, yep, this will work. Yep, this will work. Yep, this will work. And so anyway, this little scrap paper right here that is kind of a mint color, tone on tone. I get out my Creative Memories border punch system and get out my notebook one. And you're watching me punch that out. And then I'm going to layer that right back under that photograph of my little guy and myself. And this photograph was taken 2019 on his birthday. We don't do like birthday parties. You know, we might switch it up and get with some family members, but I don't know. I've always kept it like a family time. And I think that's just because we have such busy lives and both my husband and I work full time. And so I make it more of a family event and a special day, and they get to choose. And I did this with my two older kids, and they get to choose what they want for breakfast, lunch, and some place to go. But it has to be, you know, fairly reasonable, and it has to be fun, and that we all are going to enjoy it. So we took a drive to a zoo my little guy discovered on the border of North Carolina, South Carolina. Well, I shouldn't say on the border, because I think we drove into South Carolina an hour. But anyway, I don't remember the name right now. I do have the brochure and everything, and I have to go hunt for it. I'm pretty sure I know exactly where I put that brochure, because I kind of keep those all together so that I can use that later to document and do journaling. And sometimes I put the brochures on the front of my page or behind my page, or I'll make a separate page. I don't always film those, rarely film those. But if it's someplace that we've been to for the first time, and I don't think that we'll go back very often, I'll keep the brochure and add it into the scrapbook somehow. All right. So anyway, so we went to the zoo for his birthday. All right. I'm working on that cluster in the upper left-hand corner, and I got out my sticker book. You can see that right there. And I think it's just American Craft one. It wasn't one I don't think was released in a certain design. Sometimes American Crafts put some together that went with several different collections. So anyway, I got out that clear type sticker, backed it on white cardstock. It said good vibes. It was too filling, too square right there. So I decided to fussy cut the word good vibes out. While you watch me do that for a second, just let me tell you what it says in the upper right-hand cluster, which is a clear sticker. And I didn't put that on white cardstock. I stuck that right on the background paper, which is like a clipboard with a notebook on it. And I have another clear sticker from that pad that is of a bright green moth. And then the round circle says one day at a time. And then I put it's like an enamel dot, but it's acrylic. And then there's a puffy sticker of a yellow moth right above that little saint. And I will bring in a puffy bow. And all those little puffy items are stickers that came out with Pink Paisley collection a couple years ago. I found this little heart right there. The over to the lower right cluster, there is an old flower sticker that says Sweet Summer Smiles. Behind it, I put a puffy sticker of flowers that says blue. Then I have that green arrow. Then I have a chipboard with a yellow bug on it. I would not call it a ladybug. Then I have another puffy sticker that's tucked under that pink flower, and it says All My Love. And now I got out a very old, close to my heart, blue pen. And when I want to be matchy-matchy, I get this blue pen out, and I either use it for journaling or I use it for outlining here. Now I did something a little bit different. Normally I do like little X's or just a little straight squiggly line in three spots, but I decided to do loop-de-loops. And that's because I knew I was going to add some thread to this layout, so I wanted to bring that theme in, but my loop-de-loops didn't turn out that well, but it's A-okay. The focus is to the photograph of me and my little guy. I don't think you really look at my wonky little loop-to-loops. You would think something like that would be easy, but if you know me, I don't draw even stick people. I'm very crafty and creative, but if you ask me to draw or do something, man, I'll mess it up for you. I cannot draw. All right, so here comes in my thread, which I just pick up at Walmart, and you'll have it on hand for a lifetime, unless you do a lot of sewing. And I just tuck that in there, and then I take one in and kind of loop it up around the title so your eye will move that way. So I have lots of visual interest going on this layout, lots of different textures and movement. Be sure to go check out the other ladies. Their links will be listed below, and that will be Crystal, Christy, Lisa, Jennifer, and Daisy. I will have their, like I said, their links to their channel listed below. Get out your photographs, document those memories in a fun, creative way. If you're not a subscriber, I'd love to have you as a subscriber. Give a thumbs up. That brings traffic to our channel. And here are the close-ups. And we post on the 15th of every month. I appreciate you all. Have an awesome day. Bye.